Hi, good morning students. Welcome to today's class. We'll discuss leftover topics in our unit 1 partial differential equation. So in last class we discussed linear first order partial differential equation Lagrange's equation and how to solve Lagrange's equation two methods. One is method of grouping and another one is method of multipliers. Now today's class we'll discuss nonlinear partial differential equations first order. Today's class we discuss nonlinear partial differential equations of first order. Okay, see the definition of a nonlinear partial differential equation. A PDE which involves first order partial derivatives p and q with degree higher than 1, with a degree higher than 1, that means like p square, p cube, p power 4, like that. Earlier in Lagrange's and lower classes we discuss only we discuss degree is what, 1, not more than 1. Here we are going to solve the sums degree is higher than 1 and product of PQ, that means PQ terms is called a nonlinear PDE. Example, P square plus PQ equal to Q square. Okay. So then what is the solution of this nonlinear PDE? Generally, to solve nonlinear PDE, we use Charpitz method. Generally, to solve nonlinear PDE, we use Charpitz method. Okay. So today we'll discuss four types of nonlinear PDEs. That is, first one, type 1. So f of p comma q is equal to 0, that means only p and q terms, only p and q terms, that means there is no x term, there is no y term, there is no z terms, only p and q terms, that is type 1. Next, type 2, f of p comma q comma z equal to 0, that means p terms, q terms, z terms, there is no x and y terms. Then third type, f of x comma p equal to g of y comma q, that means p and x terms one side, y and q terms another side, that is variable separable method, nothing but variable separable method. Then fourth type, z is equal to px plus qy plus f of p comma q, z is equal to px plus qy f of p comma q, it is what, that is Clairaut's method, nothing but Clairaut's form. So these are the four types today we are going to discuss. Understand? So what is the definition of nonlinear PDE? A PDE which involves first order partial derivatives p and q with a degree higher than 1. Degree should be more than 1. Okay. And PQ terms is called a nonlinear PDE. So what is the method? Charpitz method we have. Charpitz method also is very, very important. It will come for 10 marks directly. So that we'll discuss after discussing these four types. Okay. So let us start first type. What is our first type? F of p comma q equal to, f of p comma q equal to, okay. So we solve type 1. What is type 1? F of p comma q is equal to 0. What is the type 1 form of the equation? F of p comma q is equal to 0. To solve, f of p comma q is equal to 0. These type of sums. To solve this, what we have to do? We have to take the required solution. Required solution z is equal ax plus by plus c, that is equal ax plus by plus c. So partially differentiate with respect to x and y. So dou z by dou x is equal to, I get a, and dou z by dou y, what I get here, I get b. So dou z by dou x is what, p, and dou z by dou y is what, q. So p is equal to a and q is equal to b. So therefore our solution becomes, therefore, complete solution, z is equal, what is my a? A is p, px plus qy plus c, okay? Px plus qy plus c, right? Now we'll see. Now one second, not px, ma, z is equal to a, we have to substitute in place of p, a, in place of q, b. So therefore, what complete solution or required solution, I'll get ax, and that b value also you need to change in terms of y, okay? So phi of a into y plus c. Let us see one problem. What is the problem? What will ask you? Solve only pq terms, right? Solve pq is equal to 3. Solve pq is equal to 3. Solution. So what we have to do here? Let p is equal to small a and q q is equal small b, right? So what is given? So given becomes a b is equal 3. So what is my b value? B is 3 by a. B is 3 by a. So therefore, complete solution or required solution z is equal ax plus by plus c, right? So that is equal ax plus, what is b value we got? 3 by a into y plus c. That's it. Okay. So you need to eliminate p and q and you need to get the solution in this form. Okay. Next problem. Solve p square plus q square is equal sum 4. P square plus q square is equal 4. So this equation contains only p and q. So it is a first type, correct? So therefore, what is our solution, required solution? Z is equal ax plus by plus c. What is the required solution? Z is equal ax plus by plus c. Okay. For that, let p is equal a and q is equal b. Or you differentiate this one partially with respect to x, you get dou z by dou x is equal a and dou z by dou y is equal b. Okay, substitute here. So therefore, marked as this is 1. Ma. Therefore, from 1, that implies from 1, what is my p value? A square. What is my q value? B. It becomes b square. So b square is equal 4. So b square is equal 4 minus a square. B square is equal 4 minus a square. B is equal plus or minus square root of 4 minus a square. Or you will just take it plus. Clear? So therefore, required solution becomes z is equal to ax plus, what is my b value? Square root of 4 minus a square into y plus c. Okay? Now we'll see another problem. Problem number 3. Solve. These type of sums will come for 2 marks. So what I discussed earlier, elimination of arbitrary function, formation of PDE, elimination of arbitrary constant. On that method we get 1-2 mark question. And here nonlinear PDE, on this type we get 1-2 mark question mark. Solve PQ plus P plus Q is equal 0. Solve PQ plus P plus Q is equal 0. Solution. So what is the required solution? Z is equal AX plus BY plus C, right? So let P is equal small a and Q is equal small b, right? So this is marked as equation number 1. So from 1, what is P value A? What is Q value B? And P is A, Q is B equal to 0. I need B value. So from here and here, take out B common. If I take B common, I get A plus 1. And this plus A, send this side. So this is called minus A. So therefore, B is equal minus A by A plus 1. So therefore, required solution Z is equal AX plus B. What is my B value? What we got here? Minus A by A plus 1 into Y plus C. Okay? Now, we'll see another. Next, we'll see type 2. What is our type 2? F of Z comma P comma Q is equal to 0. Problem in the type F of Z comma P comma Q is equal to 0, right? So to solve these type of problems, what we have to do, what is working rule here? To solve this type of problem, first let u is equal to x plus ay and put p is equal to dz by du and q is equal to a into dz by du. Let u is equal to x plus ay and put p is equal to dz by du and q is equal to a into dz by du. So our problem will convert in terms of dz by du and a into dz by du and z. Then solve for z and u. You will get the answer. Let us see the problem. Solve p square plus pq is equal to z square. So this is in terms of, this problem is given in terms of p, q and z. This p, q and z. Okay. So what we have to do here, let z is equal to f of u, where u is equal to x plus ay, right? Where u is equal to x plus ay. So what is my p becomes? P is equal dz by du and q is equal a into dz by du, right? So substitute from given. So what I get here, what is p square? P square is dz by du whole square plus p into q dz by du into q is what? A into dz by du equal to z square. What is z? Z square is as it is, right? So we have to integrate and we have to solve z and u values, okay? So now here dz by du whole square is common. Dz by du and dz by du becomes dz by du whole square, take out common, 1 plus a equal to z square, right? So dz by du whole square equal to z square by 1 plus a. Cross multiply this 1 plus a this side. So what I get here, dz by du whole square is equal to z square by 1 plus a. Now dz by du, dz by du equal to, square will come this side, it becomes square root of z square by 1 plus a. So therefore this is equal, z square becomes z and root 1 plus a. Now integrate by using the method variable separable. So dz is here, z is here, cross multiply this z this side. So dz by z equal to, cross multiply this du this side, du by square root of 1 plus a. Now integrate. If I integrate, what I get here? Integration of 1 by z dz is equal integration of du by square root of 1 plus a. So integration of 1 by z is log z, and integration of du is what? U by square root of 1 plus a as it is plus c. So log z is equal to u. What is u? We took x plus a y by square root of 1 plus a plus c. That is the required solution, okay? Next, problem number 2. Solve z is equal to p square plus q square. So here identifying the type is very, very important. What is first type we did? F of p comma q equal to 0, only p q terms, right? Here we have p terms, q terms and z terms. So it will go to type 2, okay? So let z is equal to f of u, where u is x plus ay, and put p is equal to dz by du, q is equal to a into dz by du. So from given, what we get here, z is as it is. What is my p value? Dz by du whole square plus q square. What is my q value? A into dz by du. So whole square we'll get, right? So p is dz by du, q is a into dz by du. So this implies z is equal to dz by du whole square, take out common, dz by du whole square will come common, I get 1 plus a square. So I need variable separable, so cross multiply this side. So this implies z by 1 plus a square equal to dz by du whole square. So send this square this side, it becomes square root. So therefore this implies dz by du is equal to square root of z by 1 plus a square, correct? So this can be written as root z by square root of 1 plus a square. So now variable separable method, cross multiply z this side, dz by root z equal to du by root 1 plus a square, right? Now integrate. If I integrate here, 1 by root z, 1 by root x integration is what? 2 root x. So 1 by root z integration is what? 2 root z equal to integration of du becomes u, and this is constant as it is, plus c. So 2 root z is equal to, what is u? We took x plus a y by square root of 1 plus a square plus c. This is our required solution, okay? Understand this problem. What we did here, let z is equal to f of u, and where u is equal to x plus a y. Why we are doing here? Because it is a type 2. We got the problem in terms of p, q and z. So and p is equal to dz by du, q is equal to a into dz by du, substitute in the given problem, take out common, and try to solve variable separable. So we separated dz terms one side, we separated du terms one side, and we integrated. So we got the required solution. Okay. Next, sum number 3, solve p cube is equal to qz. So same method, type 2, only we have p terms, q terms, and z terms. So let z is equal to f of u, where u is equal to x plus ay. So put p is equal to dz by du and q is equal to a into dz by du. What I get here from given p cube, what is p? Dz by du whole cube equal to q. What is q? A into dz by du into z. Correct. So 1 dz by du and 1 dz by du got cancel. So 1 I will get here, got cancel. So what is left here? Dz by du whole square, dz by du whole square equal to az. Send the square this side. So dz by du equal to square root of az. Square root of az. This can be written as root a into root z. Right. Now variable separable method, say cross multiply root z that side. So dz by root z equal to root a into du, root a into du. Now what we have to do, you need to integrate. If I integrate here, 1 by root z integration 2 root z equal to root a is constant, integration of du is what, u plus c. So therefore required solution 2 root z equal to root a. What is my u value? X plus ay plus c. Okay. So it's a simple. Only the thing is what? You need to substitute p value, you need to substitute q value, and you need to make z terms one side and u terms another side. Then integrate, you will get the required solution. Next, sum number 4. Solve 4p square plus 4q square is equal to 1 by z square. Okay, so we have only p terms, q terms, and z terms. This will come to type 2. So let z is equal to f of u, where u is equal to x plus ay. Put p is equal to dz by du and q is equal to a into dz by du. From given, what I get? 4p square. P square is what? Dz by du whole square plus 4q square. What is q square? Becomes a square dz by du whole square equal to 1 by z square, right? So now after that, you need to separate variables and variable separable method. You need to use variable separable method. For that, take out 4 dz by du common. 4 dz by du whole square is common. So what I get here? 1, and here a square equal to 1 by z square, right? I need dz by du. So dz by du whole square is equal to, cross multiply these two terms, it becomes 1 by z square into 4 into 1 plus a square. Okay. Now send this square, send the square this side. So what I get here? Dz by du is equal to square root of 1 by 4 z square into 1 plus a square. Okay. See here, I will explain you again. So first what we took, z is equal to f of u, where u is equal to x plus ay, and put p is equal to dz by du, q is equal to a into dz by du. Then from given, what I get here, p is what? Dz by du, 4 into dz by du whole square plus 4 into q square becomes a square into dz by du whole square. That is equal to 1 by z square. Now, from these two terms, I took the common, 4 is common and dz by du whole square is common. So what is left here? 1 is left here, and what is left here? A square is left. That is equal to 1 by z square. So cross multiply this part, 1 by z square into 4 into 1 plus a square. Now, square, we'll send it this side, it becomes square root. I need z terms one side and u terms another side. So therefore, this is equal to dz by du is equal to 1 by, what I get? Square root of 1 by 4, which is 2, and square root of z square is z, and root 1 plus a square is as it is. So now, send this z, cross multiply z this side, z into dz equal to, z into dz equal to, this part will come here, du by 2 root of 1 plus a square. Now integrate, If I integrate here, integration of z is what? Z square by 2 equal integration of du is what? U by 2 into square root of 1 plus a square plus c. What is our u? U is x plus ay. Therefore, required solution z square by 2 is equal u is what? X plus ay by 2 into square root of 1 plus a square plus c. Understand? So, like this, you need to eliminate p and q and you need to get in terms of x and y. Okay? Okay, so we completed type 2 ma. Now let us take for homework. So first one is what? Solve p square plus p is equal to q square. So which type it is? Only p and q terms are there. It is a type 1 problem. And here also p, q terms are there. This one is also type 1. And here also type 1. Okay, so first three problems are type 1. And second p, q, z. P, q, z. So sum number 4 and sum number 5 is type 2 problems. Okay, so we discuss type 1 and type 2. You solve these three problems, type 1 and these two problems and type 2, and send me mail if you have any doubts and all. Okay, let us will continue other type 3 and type 4 in tomorrow's class. So try to practice in all the problems which I'm explaining every day. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.